Fisheries, representing the Most Honourable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister of Jamaica. The Honourable Xavier Main, Minister of State of the Ministry of Labour and Security. Her Excellency, Marcia Yvette Gilbert Roberts, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. His Excellency Donald Tappan, U.S. Ambassador to Jamaica. Mr. Horace Daly, Member of Parliament and Opposition Spokesperson on Labour, Social Security and Special Abilities. Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Labour and Social Security. Mrs. Mathilda Scarlett Jones, Chief Liaison Officer, Jamaica Central Labour Organization. Mr. Jason Smith, Chief Executive Officer, Yummy Jobs UK. Ms. Patricia Turnbull, Director Human Resource, Old Edwards Hotel. Mrs. Margaret Campbell, Country Manager, Grace Kennedy, Money Services. Distinguished awardees, members of the media, the staff of the Ministry of Labour and Social Security, Jamaica Central Labour Organization, and Florida East Coast Travel Services. Good evening. Welcome to the 77th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Agricultural Program and the 50th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Hospitality Program. It is indeed a time to celebrate. I think you should clap yourselves, those of you who are on that program and those of you who facilitated this program for so many years. To start things off, I'd like to ask Mr. Cecil Brown to come and offer prayer. Mr. Brown?
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thank you for blessing us with this beautiful evening to celebrate. Thank you for the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, for the impact it continues to have on our island, Jamaica. Thank you for our stakeholders who have labored with us in achieving these milestones. 50 years re our hospitality and 77 years re our agricultural program. We say thank you. Thank you for the many families who have benefited. We pray for vision for the continuity of these programs. As we gather for a time of reflection, thanksgiving, and fellowship, we pray that you'll bless this evening proceeding and watch over us. In your son's name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. And yes, so many of you have participated in this program over so many years, and so many before you. I don't believe that there is any family in Jamaica who has not had someone who has participated in the farm work program or the hospitality program. Are you in agreement? The families, those of us who are from rural Jamaica understand the importance of these programs. And now it gives me great pleasure to ask the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Labour and Social Security, Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden, to bring her opening remarks.
Honourable Audley Shaw, Minister of Industry, Commerce and Agriculture, representing the Most Honourable Prime Minister Andrew Holness. Honourable Shaheeni Robinson, Minister of Labour and Social Security. Honourable Xavier Main, Minister of State in the Ministry. I'd like to acknowledge the Custos, Honourable Roy Mochette, Custos Rotolorum for Trelawney, for the parish of Trelawney. Mayor Colin Granger, I'd like to also acknowledge the Speaker of the House, Honorable Colonel Charles, and Mr. Horace Daly, opposition spokesperson for Social Security and Labor Matters. Let me also acknowledge my counterpart, Permanent Secretary, Ambassador Gilbert Roberts, and our special guest as well, Ambassador Tapia, acknowledge you, Ambassador Tapia, and let me welcome you all to our function. Let me also acknowledge all the employers who are here, Flex, staff of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, employers, employees, well-wishers, everyone, good evening. It is my pleasure to share with you in this evening's award and dinner ceremony as we celebrate 77th and 50th anniversary of the U.S. Agriculture and Hospitality Programs. It is indeed a special occasion because it gives us the opportunity to highlight and salute some of the persons who have made these programs possible. Persons who have for major parts of their lives given service with dedication and pride. It also allows us to pay homage to a bit of our history and the relationship between two countries. And as I said to Ambassador Tapia earlier, we're too close not to be close. Over the years, these programs have contributed significantly to the growth and development of the Jamaican economy. The Jamaican economy is impacted by the inflows of remittances, other benefits to the country, such as technology, transfer, improved productivity, high levels of savings, higher levels of entrepreneurship, and of course, higher levels of employment and reduced poverty. This is not just an employment program, but is the gateway for many persons to enhance their lives. Through these programs, many Jamaicans are now in a better position to provide for themselves and their families, and many employers in the United States are in a better position with respect to their businesses and the success. Without employers who are willing to make an investment and take the risk, there will be no program. Our employers have placed and continue to place a great deal of trust in our workers as they continue to request our workers for many years. Like anything else in life, the program comes with its challenges, but the government of Jamaica through the Ministry of Labor and Social Security is committed to maintaining the integrity of the program. So tonight, as we take time out to honor some of our loyal employers and employees who have contributed significantly to the success of the programs, I invite you all to enjoy the journey with us. We will see the fruits that bear from the commitment and dedication of thousands of workers and employers alike. To all our employers who are here, let me say none of this would have been possible without you. You have kept faith in the Jamaican workers. You have kept faith in the Jamaican workers because you have seen what the Jamaican workers can do. I implore you to continue investing in our workers, and I guarantee you that they will not disappoint. Employees, workers, you have been true ambassadors for this country, true ambassadors for your community and families. Because of your outstanding work ethic, you continue to pave the way for other Jamaicans. I want you to know that we in the ministry and the country is proud of you and all that you do to build Jamaica and to build the United States. In closing, let me publicly thank all the stakeholders, and let me thank all the dedicated, hardworking staff of the ministry who have made this function a success. It's so successful that we have more than we thought would be here. So, thank you all, and I'm sure we will have a wonderful evening. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. I could hear in that presentation that you are in fact speaking about partnerships, and that is what life is about. We are pleased to let you know that this event is being streamed live on the JIS website, www.jis.gov.jm, the JIS Facebook page, and the Ministry of Labor and Social Security Facebook page as well. So just to let you know that we are gone abroad, just like the farm workers and the hospitality workers go abroad, okay? Mr. Horace Daly, might I invite you now to bring your presentation. Member of Parliament, Opposition Spokesperson on Labour, Social Security and Special Abilities, Mr. Horace Daly.
Please. Thank you very much. Master of Ceremonies, my friend and my sister, Honourable Minister Shiny Robinson, my very good friend for many, many years. Your Worship the Mayor, Honorable Costas, Ministers, Audley Shaw, and Minister Main, the Speaker of the House of the Jamaica Parliament, Honorable Pernell Charles. We have a little problem on Tuesday, but we have no impeachment trial going on. Your Excellency, Donald Tapia, Ambassador of the United States to Jamaica, Permanent Secretaries, my friend Colette, and my other Permanent Secretary friend. Members of staff of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, members of the Liaison Service, whatever it's called now, farmers, owners, friends, family members, and all those who support the U.S. Overseas Program, I would like to not only welcome you to Jamaica, but I would like to welcome you to Bracco, to Mayor Bracco, a property which is owned by the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. You can clap that, you know, Liz. I have three things I would like to say in my greetings. There is a special person here that I have to acknowledge, and her name is Denise from the Breakers Hotel, who, when I just became the Minister of Labor, I took the first batch of workers to the Breakers. Denise, it's so good to see you once again with your staff. I'd like to recognize also Joe and the team from FLEC and all those who have worked over the years to sustain and maintain this overseas program in the United States. We first ventured out into the farms when the United States needed workers, and we were happy as a country to supply those hardworking workers from Jamaica and other Caribbean countries. 50 years ago, we ventured into the hospitality industry, the hotel workers, and we're happy that we have thousands of workers working in the United States, providing service to all those who visit the hotels where people work. My second point is to commend and to congratulate the staff in the ministry who I have worked with. The Speaker of the House was a Minister of Labor he worked with, and now Minister Shiny Robinson is working with, and Minister Main, because in the staff in the Ministry of Labor, you find one of the most dedicated and hardworking, committed public servants. And I would like you all to salute them. My third point is, there was a time when the foreign exchange that these farmers and hotel workers earned played a very important part in financing the budget of Jamaica. There was a time in the mid-70s and during the 80s when the earnings from the farm work program and the earnings from the hotel program went straight to the Bank of Jamaica to help with our reserves. We don't need that anymore. We have far past that. And I have to say, I lift my hat to the farm workers and the hotel workers who, after 77 years, have maintained and have kept the Jamaican flag flying high in the United States. A lot of them are here tonight. Some doing 42 years. Some doing 41 years. But also there's a person here who is doing 55 years in the farm work program. I salute you, Mr. August Morgan. Could you please stand, Mr. Morgan? 55 years.
Thank you.
77 years, Jamaica government and the United States Department of Labor have been operating the U.S. Farm Work Program. And there are some personnel, some seated here, some their sons are here, some their daughters are here, who have been carrying out the tradition of the farms. There's one farm, V.G. Minard and Sons in New York, that is doing 72 years of the 77 years with employing Jamaican workers. The Pioneer Fruit Farms from New York, 72 years of participation with Jamaican workers. And you have the Erd and Son Inc. I think I went to this farm when I was minister, 72 years. I want to tell you that we in Jamaica, the government, you know, I'm in opposition now, you know, I'm not the minister, but one day I hope to be the minister again. But on this matter of the overseas program, you will not find a divide between Shaini Robinson, Honorable Minister, and myself as a former minister and the opposition spokesman for Labour when it comes on to this program. We are at one. We want the best for the program and would like to have more employers engaged in the program. I want to thank you on behalf of Jamaica for employing our Jamaican workers in your homes, in your hotels, and on your farms. And I hope that you will continue for another 77 years. God bless you all.
Thank you so much, Mr. Daly. And for those persons who are coming in after we started, welcome. I know you're going to be having a really good evening. It now gives me great pleasure to invite the Honorable Shaini Robinson, Member of Parliament and Minister of Labour and Social Security, to address us. Madam Minister.
Thank you, Madam MC, for doing more than your MC duties with me. Thank you so much. U.S. Ambassador to Jamaica, Mr. Donald Tapio, we want to really welcome you here this evening, and we thank you for being with us. The Minister of Industry and Commerce, Agriculture and Fisheries, the Honorable Audley Shaw, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden, Director of Manpower Services, our own Mrs. Andrea Miller-Sennett, the Chief Liaison Officer in the Jamaica Central Organization, Mrs. Methelina Scarlett-Jones, representatives from the U.S. Department of State and the U.S. Embassy, Chairman of the Valley Growers Association, Mr. Joe Russo, General Manager for the Florida East Coast Travel Services, Mr. Joe Hobbs, tonight's awardees, other distinguished guests, stakeholders, and friends of the program. Good evening to you. And I've not omitted my speaker, and they say you save the best wine for last. Speaker Charles, I want to acknowledge you, my colleague, my brother, my friend, Horace Daly, Member of Parliament for North Clarendon. The Custos, Honorable Paul Mouchet, His Worship the Mayor, Colin Gager, and really leaving the best for the last, my own Minister of State in the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, the Honorable Xavier Main. Well, ladies and gentlemen, again, good evening. Let me welcome all of you to this evening's awards ceremony for the Jamaica U.S. Employment Program here at the enchanting and magnificent Melia Bracco property in Trelawney. I bring warm welcomes and greetings. The meetings of today and tomorrow will extensively cover the inner workings, policies, and framework of the program. However, this evening is for festivities, awards, and a show of appreciation to all those who have played a significant role in the continued success of the Jamaica U.S. Employment Program. For the first time in approximately 10 years, we're gathered this evening to celebrate the successes of two historical events in the genesis of our agriculture and hospitality arrangements that have endured decades and generations. Ladies and gentlemen, if you examine the history books, you will realize that this program has earned the right to be etched into the libraries of world history. I will use the number 77 and give you 7 great facts in world history. The U.S. Jamaican agricultural program existed before Gandhi was assassinated, before the hydrogen bomb, before Queen Elizabeth I was crowned, and that's a long time ago, before Martin Luther King had a dream and Rosa Parks sat in the front of the bus, before man walked on the moon, before Fidel Castro became Cuba's president. And speaking of presidents, this program has seen 14 U.S. presidents, from Franklin D. Roosevelt to our current president, Donald J. Trump. The impact, the economic impact for both our countries cannot be downplayed or ignored. Last year, we sent approximately 7,000 workers to fill positions in the agricultural and hospitality sectors in the United States. For every job our workers have, approximately 4 U.S. jobs are created. So listen to this, ladies and gentlemen. It is estimated that over the last 5 years, workers' earnings have exceeded over U.S. $300 million. Add that to the thousands and thousands of children who have gone from preparatory level to tertiary over these many years, how many doctors, lawyers, engineers, teachers, and nurses have been created out of this program, both here in Jamaica, and the many who have qualified to attend school in the United States. The countless homes bought, mortgages paid, medical costs covered, and a sense of social security made certain in the lives of so many all across this country. And Ambassador Tapio, I think it would be remiss of me not to point out that this is a mutually beneficial program, because you get our workers to plant and harvest your crops, and our workers are put to work. And for a program to have lasted 77 years, I believe that both sides must be doing something right. And this is the finest, one of the finest examples of U.S.-Jamaica cooperation. So I want to use this opportunity to thank the United States for the tried, tested, and proven partnership shared with Jamaica in administering the Agricultural Workers Program over the last 77 years and the Hospitality Program for the last 50 years. I want to thank each and everyone who has played a role in these programs. Hopefully, having the U.S. Ambassador and the Ministers of Labor and Agriculture in one place might be the beginning of even greater things to come. We never know. Those who help to facilitate the employment opportunities, visas and travel arrangements, and liaison services, we are grateful to you. As always, I must pay tribute and say thanks to my hardworking and dedicated staff at the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. And the staff at the Ministry of Social Security goes well beyond the call of duty. A lot of times they are impacted in floods and hurricanes, and the ever impatient public wants them to come out, but we ask, bear with them, because they live in those same communities where you live and might have been impacted. They give of themselves unselfishly, and I want to tell you that at the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, we say that we take care of you from the womb to the tomb, and we deal with the most vulnerable people in the society. So there, we know what patience is, we know what respect is, and our staff members are up to the task, and they deliver. We want to thank them for working long hours to ensuring hundreds and thousands of workers are processed in order to take and make those flights. The employers continue to place their faith in the capabilities and commitment of our Jamaican worker year after year. We appreciate the continued confidence and will continue to supply the very best workers. May we continue to share this program for another 77 years and enjoy even greater benefit and increased success levels. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and do enjoy the rest of the evening's proceedings.
Thank you, Minister. I particularly liked your sharing of those seven great facts, that this program was around before so many important milestones took place. And in Jamaica, I would say, this program has been around from Saltfish a Shingle Roof. So when my Jamaican farm workers and hospitality were on and I'll clap it. And so we talk. So just connect with me. It their own long, long time. As a matter of fact, what was that? I heard somebody say something. It hollered at me. It hollered at me. So for those who are non-Jamaicans in the room, we do have two languages here. We have Jamaican, I may talk right now, and we have the English language, which is our official language. So we're good for Suno. We're happy Suno Day here. We're so happy that you can share this occasion with us. You hear that? Right, might I just acknowledge, Mrs. Grace Burnett, where are you? I want to say thanks for all the support that you give, CEO of Grace Kennedy Financial Group and Grace Kennedy Money Services Limited. Thank you so very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Ambassador Donald Tapia, U.S. Ambassador to Jamaica. His Excellency, I gather that he has been learning a lot about Jamaica and the Jamaican culture. He's doing things, going places, and really just absorbing all that makes us Jamaica. I don't know if he's going to speak to us in Jamaican or if he's going to even say one phrase that will make us say, yes, he's got it. Ambassador, sir, could you welcome him, please?
I'm learning. First thing you know, when I hear the, I want to thank you for the honor of being here this evening, because it's a great honor to be here to represent the United States of America. When I look and I listen to the number of, that it's been 77 years, don't be shocked, I was 5 years old. So I just wanted you to know that, you know. So. I had a great opportunity to grow up, and I did actually grow up, believe it or not, on a farm when I was in high school, and I do know how hard farm workers work. I never had the appreciation until I was on a farm and watching and working in the fields and so forth, so I do know. But I want to thank you again for the opportunity to speak, especially alongside our honorable in Minister Shaw. It seems like Minister Shaw and I are becoming, we're going to become dance partners, because it's the third time that I've seen him this week. So it's always great seeing Minister Shaw. You know, along, and the main thing I wanted to congratulate you your government and all the public and private stakeholders. It means so much to us at this event for their work in supporting the success of the real people, the one that, that make it happen. So, do I have to smile? The real people who really truly that make it happen, the program. I want to congratulate the U.S. employers, employees, the Jamaican employees, particularly to Jamaican employees, because they're so important to our economy here. And I say our economy because I feel that this is my home now. Their efforts have made Jamaica one of the largest participants in the temporary work program globally, second only, of course, to Mexico, which, of course, you know, because of the farm workers are so close to California. It's a win-win for as well as we use the words. But the temporary worker program represents a perfect example of how the need and skill of two countries can combine the productive and powerful results for both of our countries. Jamaica has been, you know, traveling to the U.S. for over seven decades, as you've heard this evening. And it was amazing when I heard that it was seven decades that you have been traveling and sending Jamaicans to the U.S. The workers brings nearly, and I like her number better than the number that they gave me. The workers have bring $100 million in earnings back to Jamaica. I like her numbers, $300 million. So, you know, of course I'd like the upper number instead of the lower number, which turns help support the small businesses, farms, and families here. It's very important that this, the money comes back to the economy within your own country, and that's very, very important. Strong bonds have formed along the way, and think about this, strong bonds. Pickers and farmers have developed friendships that find workers returning to the same farms year after year, and even from one generation to another. This is a generational program. It has been a generational program. We've seen our kids grow to follow their fathers into the fields and so forth. It's a program that brings family together in many cases. Sharing work has always meant sharing experiences and building connections between Jamaica and America. The program itself continues to grow. The participants of the Jamaican worker in U.S. hospitality industry and increased substantially in the recent years, as we heard this evening. Jamaican workers can be found at hotels and resorts, and listen to this one, in 42 states in the United States. Now, we have a job to do because that means there's eight states that are not bringing Jamaican workers. There has been a record growth in opportunities in agriculture workers in the United States. The United States has seen the number of temporary agriculture workers triple in 10 years. That's a lot, triple in 10 years, to nearly 300,000 workers that come into the U.S. on a visa to the U.S. Jamaica's standing and experience in the program makes it well positioned to take full part in the oncoming expansion of the temporary worker program with opportunities in the United States. It is in our best interest that we continue to coordinate and to work together to maintain the integrity of the program. And the integrity of the program is very important to your country and our country. The U.S. mission and our partners in Washington remain ready to assist the workers, the American farmers, the Jamaican workers, to bring them to the U.S. One of the first experiences that I had in working with the Jamaican workers was when I visited Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. The fire department is staffed. It has been staffed for 31 years with the Jamaican firemen trained by the U.S. 31 years. So I guess we might say that not only for the 42, but for another country that they have assisted, the United States. Once again, I want to thank all of you for what you've done and what you're doing and what you look to the future to do, because we stand ready to help you and work with you, and whatever we can do, we will do. Before I leave the podium, there's one individual that truly has been the responsibility within the U.S. Embassy, and that is Mark. Mark, are you back there? Mark Spitz. He is the Consul General. Mark Siebel is the Consul General who issues and is responsible for issuing the H-1 and the H-2 program. Thank you, Mark, and thank you all.
Thanks, Your Excellency. And we are very happy for the partnership indeed and that it continues. Dinner will now be served. And so while we prepare for the service of the first course, I want to do a little roll call. And this is a combined roll call, because I gather there are Jamaican workers who have worked in the U.S. from all our parishes here. So let me, yes? So you agree to roll call then. So anybody here from Portland, just put up your hand. Anybody from Portland in here? Actually, hi, make we know, say you're here. Portland, clap them. Anybody from St. Thomas? Aren't you? Clap them, St. Thomas. All right, let me go back. Is anybody from St. Mary? Ah, St. Anne? Okay. Trelawney? Trelawney. That's, of course, Costas. I didn't even see when you came in. Welcome. St. James? Yes? Yes? Hanover? Where the Hanoverians not in here? Where people in from Hanover? Nobody from Haddon are here? Nobody is here from Hanover? Okay. Westmoreland? Okay. St. Elizabeth? Yes. Manchester? Oh, yes. I see hands around here. Manchester. Clarendon? Minister? There's a man from Sunbury, and Sunbury just topside of which part me come from. Topside. Yes, and then you bring in friends, Sunbury, right. Clarendon. Okay then, St. Catherine. Yes, indeed. Anybody from Kingston and St. Andrew? Have I covered all our parishes? Indeed. Enjoy your meal. I'll be back in a while. But in the meantime, you're going to be enjoying some really great music by some outstanding Jamaican musicians. I'll tell you a little bit more about them in a while. Bon appétit. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for beautiful renditions of so many popular tunes. Mark you, some of them are from yesteryear. And just keep your hands together for, let me just introduce you to the musicians. On saxophone, that was Mr. Howard Fowles. And he just has to move throughout the audience, okay? Joshua Jones on bass. Then, of course, there is on keyboards, Chris MacDonald. And the master himself on drums, Mr. Desi Jones. And while you dine, we're going to be bringing you far more in terms of entertainment. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my pleasure at this time to introduce one of our outstanding Jamaican performers. A vocalist who has wowed audiences abroad, has wowed audiences in Jamaica, and she brings her inimitable style to your special function this evening. Could you help me welcome Ms. Karen Smith?
To be with you. Special evening, and I'm so glad to be a part of it. Congratulations to all the awardees. Oh my! And I'm matching the decor. You see how my dress matches the decor, just by chance, you know. Chairs and tables look just like me. Get up in the morning.
Get up in the morning.
Slaving for bread, sir. Thank you very much. Some music that helped to put reggae music on the map. I tell you, so how I feel right now when the minister get up and dance with me already. I feel like I should just should just stop and go home now. Ladies and gentlemen, it's so nice being with you to celebrate such a great, great thing. Longevity, loyalty, and all of this. Red carpet. Never know how much I love you. You'll never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. 2, 3, 4. In the morning, fever all through the night. Sun lights up the daytime, the moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm gonna treat you right. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight. 2, 3, 4. In the morning, fever all through the night. Well, 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 everybody's got the fever. Now that is something that you all know. Fever isn't such a new thing, 'cause fever started long ago. Romeo loved Juliet. Now Juliet, she felt the same. Oh, and when he put his arms around her, he said, Julie, baby, you're my flame. Thou give it fever. When we kiss it, fever with a flaming youth. Fever, I'm a fire. And fever, yeah, I burn for soon. Captain Smith and Pocahontas, you know they had a very mad affair. Oh, and when her daddy tried to kill him, she said, Daddy, oh, don't you dare. He give me fever. With his kisses, fever when he holds me tight. Fever, I'm his missus. Now, Daddy, won't you treat him right? Now you've listened to my story. Here's a point that I have made. You know girls were born to give you fever, be it Fahrenheit or centigrade. They give you fever, oh, when you kiss them. Fever if you live, well you know that you are gonna learn. Fever, tell you sizzle. Now what a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn, yeah. It's such a lovely way to burn. I think it's such a lovely way to burn. You know it's true and I do too. Yeah, I said, whoa, oh, 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 yes. What a lovely way to burn. 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 Give me fever. Hot, hot, hot. Every time, every time. And of course, it's so nice to be able to be with you. With Desi and school. Just one.
up in clover. The night I looked at you, I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that in Jamaica.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I always enjoy sharing the stage with Desi Jones and school. Thank you, Howard Falls on saxophone.
Every time
Sensation by the Melodians. We're back, and it's such a sweet sensation to celebrate tonight. Man, we have some wonderful awards coming up later. Longevity and being in the program, the various programs, for a long time. What a big deal. What a big deal. And relationship is everything. So we really want to thank our overseas partners. We want to thank you for doing it every day and working hard so that we can be this far along. Congratulations. Boy, my heart is full. I feel good. I feel like it's me. This is great. Congrats. Congrats to you. This is dedicated to the wild love. One I love.
Time, no matter how long it takes, but how many more?
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, why do fools fall in love indeed? Cannot pay Faye for that job, you know. Fidelitas, thank you, St. Hughes girl. So, we want to, of course, thank our Lord and Savior for bringing you this far. And we want to thank him for the rest of the time ahead. Because this is a milestone, but there are far more milestones ahead. And we can't make it one moment without it. What? Can't make it one moment without him. So this is music from Ernest Smith's catalog. We like it a lot. We like it.
Jesus come today for a poor, poor girl like me. Salvation come my way, my soul is set free. Jesus come for all, and we must hear. Open up your heart today and let it be. No matter if you're teen or if you're church or if you have a crown on your head, no matter if you're out, the hearts are tossed. Jesus, we will love for one another. Sing it, children. I for Jesus, you for Jesus, all for Jesus, all for Jesus. Come to Jesus, Jesus, come for one, he come for all. Jesus Christ for us, see manger where he lies, see cross where he must die, for a wretch like me. For God so loved the world, man, woman, boy, and girl, he gave his son for you, his son for me. No matter if you're teen, or if you're good, or if you have a crown on your head, no matter if you're hard, no heart at all. Jesus, bring love for one and all. Sing it, little man. I'm for Jesus, you for Jesus, all for Jesus, all for Jesus. Come to Jesus, Jesus, come for one, he come for all. Jesus Christ today, the same as yesterday, the one and only way. Oh Lord, he is the king for me. Let it come to pass, mankind find love at last, just as it was time past. So let it be. No matter if you're teen, or if you're dead, or if you have a crown on your head, no matter if you have no heart at all. Jesus, we love for one another. Sing it, children. I'm for Jesus, I'm for Jesus, all for Jesus, all for Jesus. Come to Jesus, Jesus, come for one, he come for all. Sing it, children. I'm for Jesus, you for Jesus, all for Jesus, all for Jesus. Come to Jesus, Jesus, come for one, he come for all. Sing it, children. I'm for Jesus, you for Jesus, all for Jesus, all for Jesus. Come to Jesus, Jesus, come for one, he come for all. 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 Cannot make a move without him. Most definitely. Who invented eye makeup? I don't know. Don't work with perspiration at all. Thank you.
looking out on the morning rain. I used to feel so uninspired, and when I knew I had to face another day, Lord, whee, tired. Before the day I met you, my life was so unkind, but you're the key to my peace of mind.
So much fun at this table. You should give her another round of applause. You knew every song that she performed this evening. And can you believe she was a banker before she became a singer? Oh, banking's loss has been entertainment's gain. Let's hear it one more time for Ms. Karen Smith. Thank you, Karen, for sharing your wonderful talent with us once more. And of course, the musicians of the bandstand, Howard. Clap, bow, Joshua, Chris, and Jesse Jones. They're all my brothers. It's one big family in Jamaica. And now we're going to ask you to turn your eyes to the screen. My friends at the back, we're bringing this on a little bit before the other time that we had planned. The video is going to be played at this time. We want to thank everyone for being here and making this occasion such a wonderful event. So we have the video that's coming up now.
Right, there you go. Have a look. See if you can pay real great attention.
The first batch of participants of the government's overseas employment program in the 40s came on a military mission during World War II under the code name Swallows. At first I wondered, why swallows? So here's what I found. Swallows symbolize loyalty and hope. Loyalty because they always return home to the nest and mate in the off-season. Hope because they arrive late winter or just about early spring. And if uninterrupted, legend says your harvest will be successful. These are agile, powerful, resilient birds. So when you think about it in the context of the Jamaican experience, these migrant workers are indeed swallows. Tonight, Swallows Take Flight. It's a celebration of migrant workers in the United States who have all become a beacon of hope for our homeland, Jamaica.
Let me tell you something, sir.
It was okay.
And this will be hard.
Okay.
You make enough children happy. You make enough people stop crying. Are you blessed now? Stop yasso. God see you. God know you. And may I beg God every day to make your life shine upon you.
It is not uncommon to hear such sincere gratitude. It is not uncommon to hear the warmth of these workers. These words are the rewards that sweeten labor. However, it is quite uncommon to find a man, 97 years old, still giving thanks for this program. Kenneth Bennett was born in 1922 in the hills of Frankfield, Clarendon. 21 years later, he became one of the very first recruits for the U.S. Farm Work Program. He was one of the first to land in New Orleans, Louisiana, and one of the only ones to be honored by the World War Museum there. His political legacy is brilliant. Like a true swallow, he, along with seven friends, opened the West Indian Social Club in Hartford. The club stands today, 70 years later, as the mecca of West Indian life in the North. And from this club was also born the only cricket hall of fame in the world. We caught up with Mr. Bennett at his home in Bloomfield, Connecticut. And this is what he had to tell us.
That was the greatest thing that I ever done in my entire life when I came here in 1943. Oh yeah, that's the greatest decision that I have ever made, because some of my sisters then were young and good, and I helped put them through college and all this type of stuff there, you know. So I had nothing to regret. And when I came, my parents, they didn't want me to come, because my dear lady, we get out from field and all over the island there, you know, like in Clarendon and Upper Clarendon and Spraley, everybody gathered from field. And the train long like from here to across in the wood there, loading up on it, going to Kingston to get on the boat. Mother and father crying, father crying, because people think we're going to get killed. Ship going to sink. We communicate with the government of Jamaica. If you have any problem with any farmer here or all that, you have a representative that would come and listen to your story, you know. And then if you didn't want to work, they could make you work.
To carefully outline the role of the liaison service, we turn to longtime civil servant and former deputy chief of administration at the Jamaica Central Labor Organization, JCLO, Mr. Cecil Ware. Mr. Ware served the JCLO for almost 40 years. He has seen and done a lot for the welfare of migrant workers from the Caribbean.
As a liaison officer, my primary responsibility was to look about the welfare of Caribbean agricultural and non-agricultural workers recruited from participating colonial islands to work in the United States of America. The West Indies Liaison Service was conceived in 1943 after workers began arriving from the British-controlled Caribbean colonies for employment, originally on farms and subsequently in industries in the United States.
By 2000, Cecil Ware passed the baton to Mr. Sheldon Brown, who now underscores the importance of the JCLO program.
Well, the Jamaican program is extremely unique in that the government of Jamaica takes this program very seriously. They maintain a qualified pre-screened pool of workers at all times, so that any employer who wants to come down is free to come down and recruit and select from that pool. One of the most unique things is that they provide a liaison officer within each state where we have Jamaicans to liaise between the employer and the government and also the worker to make sure that things run smoothly and to make sure the welfare of the workers is protected, but that also the employer is pretty much pleased with the entire labor force that they have selected from Jamaica.
But don't take our word for it. To really understand the value and meaning of a program like this one, we went in search of the workers' perspective.
These liaison officer goes over and beyond and extend themselves, you know, for the program, for Jamaica. And we just want to thank them.
The program, though, also took center stage on Capitol Hill. When John Weiss appeared before the House Judiciary Committee on July 19, 2017.
It's important to note, though, that our community has rallied around these H2A workers, and they've actually become part of our community. Each August, our Jamaican H2A workers celebrate the Jamaican Independence Day at one of our labor camps. The workers prepare authentic Jamaican food, play music, and host a soccer tournament. The event is open to the public and serves as an annual fundraiser to support charities back in the home country of Jamaica. Our local sheriff told me before I came out, I remember the days when we used to come to the labor camps a couple times a week and we were picking people up. Now our off-duty officers are coming to your labor camp to pick workers up to go to church. There's a significant difference that has occurred and change that's occurred as our workforce has changed.
By the beginning of 2000, the hospitality program, which got off the ground in the late 60s, really picked up steam with a cadre of outstanding professionals. And in 2005, three powerful hurricanes hit the United States, the worst of them, Hurricane Katrina. Barbara Vale, an outstanding H2B associate, remembers her time on the program.
I remember vividly, went on an extension in 2005 to Lake Charles, Louisiana, got caught in a hurricane, and there were six liaison officers, along with Mrs. Barbara DaCosta, to locate us, to make sure we were safe, find out where other people was. I cannot thank them enough. There was never a need when you take up that phone that he or she liaison officer would not respond, would respond to you. If you leave a message, somebody was always there to return your call. I remember I got sick, went to the hospital, my roommates called, and my liaison officer was on it.
For many of the migrant workers, they're typically away from home for long periods. They generally arrive home in the early fall, and their children are usually born early summer. Many of them will never see their babies born. Many of them will never be home for a graduation or birthday celebration. These may seem inconsequential, but it's part of the huge sacrifice they make to be away from their families each year. They welcome visits from Jamaican officials. They truly enjoy spending time with the Minister of Labor and the Permanent Secretary. They really do know how to find joy in the moment. They have many stories to tell, but one thing is true, they're always grateful.
Well, the ministry is very legal. It is legal. And it's a place that you can trust. You don't have to worry, say, oh, you spend your money.
It's no scamming business.
Right. It's a good trade. It's the government.
It is work
trade. With the government.
It's a
very good thing to work with the government.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so that's why I want to go and make a better life for me and my children. And I want to go over there and show people that we as house people, we are good people. And we can do the job.
Yeah, we can come out.
Yes.
Now let me tell you something. We come a far way to the end. Today we are here. Everybody, let me see everybody who have a cell phone. Everybody have a phone. Somebody have two. Somebody have three. Somebody have four. Somebody have five. You know something, you can't go home at night anywhere you're in the field. You can call your darling and say, Phoebe, what's up? I love you, baby.
As the swallows continue to take flight each year, they're guided by four powerful women. These women are strong leaders, visionaries, all poised to take the program through uncharted waters. They remain steady and resolute to lead this journey.
The ministry is of the firm view that there is further scope for expansion in the United States. It is in this context that plans are afoot for me to meet with major employer groups, both in the U.S. and Canada, in the coming weeks, to promote the program and the quality of our workers with a view to securing more jobs. Mr. Speaker, we all know that Jamaican workers, wherever they're found, bring strong work ethics, discipline, productivity, and a commitment to excellence. These powerful attributes will be promoted and made available in the global marketplace. Consequently, exploratory approaches are being made in unexplored territories right here in the Caribbean and even as far away as the Australasian region. And we are actively seeking to convert these prospects into avenues for employment. Mr. Speaker, the Ministry of Labor and Social Security is working to advance prosperity.
So this journey is not an easy one, but it's the most meaningful one. To have survived 77 years is a tremendous milestone. Two countries served by one program. The lives of communities here and in the United States served by some of the very best. Two economies made stronger by loyalty and hope. The call for new swallows. Do you have it in you? For we have a journey to go.
Has captured the heart of the program. All those persons who spoke, and let me just translate, "Nuff" means plenty. You would have heard the gentleman at the start speaking about "Nuff." And Mask Kenneth Bennett, who is 97 years old, what a way to man so strong. Me know, Frank Clarendon, 7 miles from where I come from, Frankfield End. Yes, so Frankfield, he said? Aren't you? 7 miles. Me come up a little further topside up at Smithdale. You notice the language, topside. So we talk when we talk of, when we talk from country, from rural Jamaica. Minister, ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my pleasure to introduce the minister who is representing our honorable prime minister, the most honorable Andrew Holness, is not here with us this evening, but he has an able representative, the Minister of Industry, Commerce, Agriculture, and Fisheries. Will you help me welcome the Honorable Audley Shaw?
Thank you so much. My good friend, Faye. Oh, Master of Ceremonies. Let me recognize all of our distinguished guests that are with us tonight. Our Minister, Shaheen Robinson, the Ambassador of the United States of America to Jamaica, Ambassador Tapia. Let me recognize my good friend and colleague of the opposition, Mr. Daly, and I want him to stay in that position for as long as possible. Because I think he's doing such a good job in that position. Okay, I promise to behave myself for the rest of the evening. The Honorable Costas, His Worship the Mayor, Minister Xavier, who is here with us, and of course our permanent secretaries for this Ministry of Labor and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The Honorable Pernell Charles, I haven't seen him again, but he's the Speaker of the House of Representatives, who was with us. And let me just say that our special guests, our very special guests tonight, are our visitors from abroad who have been our loyal hosts of our farm workers over the years. Can we give them a very big applause? And then can we also give a very big applause to our farm workers who have worked so hard over the years. And I have to single out Mr. Augustus Morgan, 55 years. Please, stand up, Mr. Morgan, stand up. Wonderful. Let me clap harder, clap harder. Thank you so much. This evening, as we celebrate the 77th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Agricultural Program and the 50th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Hospitality Program, these programs are evidence of the long-standing mutually beneficial cooperative relationship between the United States and Jamaica, and demonstrates the close friendship and respect of our governments and people of our nations. The agricultural program predates independence. It even predates my own birth. And I'm not going to tell you the date of that. All right, okay, I'm 1952, okay. I'm just 67 years old. And this is 10 years older than me, all right? The stimulus for the program was the concern of farmers in the United States about severe shortage in domestic farm labor, as young men and women chose to enter the armed forces rather than accept the poor wages offered by farm work. It dates back to that period in our history in the late 30s and 40s, when there was civil unrest also in the Commonwealth Caribbean, largely attributable to high levels of unemployment and wartime restrictions. The United States required labor, and we had surplus labor to meet that need. From its inception, the program was a success for both farmers in the United States and the Jamaican people, who benefited from seasonal employment and the remittances they sent home. The intergovernmental agreement under which the program was initiated and was later replaced by legislative arrangements in the United States, which authorized American farmers to hire foreign workers if they could prove that no domestic workers wanted the jobs, and gave employers complete discretion in where and how to recruit workers. It's a tribute to the Jamaican workers that Jamaicans have remained the largest group of West Indian agricultural workers that are recruited, the largest group. And I would say that it's not just because of our size. I would suggest that it's because of our work ethic and the performance of the Jamaican workers. For more than 70 years, the program was administered in the United States by the Jamaica Central Labor Organization, which used to be known as the British West Indies Central Labor Organization. The arrangements with the JCLO have evolved. The primary focus of that remains the protection of the welfare and rights of Jamaican farm and hospitality workers. This group also provides a very valuable service. Liaison officers monitor the employment situation to ensure that both employers and workers adhere to the terms and conditions and procedures established under the employment contracts. Where there is nonconformity, provide the necessary guidance to address this. Throughout the many years of the operation, only men have participated in the agricultural H2A program. However, that trend was broken in June of 2017, when the first group of 64 female farm workers departed the island. 2017. This is a positive development, and we hope that more women will follow in their footsteps. Under that program, foreign workers are allowed to travel to the United States to perform non-agricultural temporary seasonal jobs for which American workers are in short supply. Jamaican hospitality workers are also primarily employed in Michigan, Florida, North and South Carolina, Georgia, Colorado, Illinois, where I went to university, by the way, Northern Illinois University. That's where I got my bachelor's and master's degrees, Ambassador. So, Ambassador, I got my bachelor's and master's degree at NIU, Northern Illinois University, in DeKalb, Illinois. So you can't trouble my visa, you know that, right? Okay, back to the script. Okay, all right, calm down, everybody. And they had occupations such as chefs, servers, front desk personnel, bartenders, housekeepers, laundry attendants, landscapers, maintenance workers, drivers, among others. Despite record low unemployment rates in both the U.S. and Jamaica, the Jamaica-USA agricultural and hospitality programs continue to provide important benefits to both countries. During the 2018-19 fiscal year, as Minister Shahini Robinson told us, close to 7,000 workers traveled to the U.S. to fill positions in the agricultural and hospitality sectors. The benefit to the U.S. economy is significant, as it is estimated that for every foreign worker brought in under one of these programs, approximately 4 U.S. jobs are created. The impact on the Jamaican economy is also striking. It is estimated that over the last 5 years, workers' earnings have exceeded U.S. $300 million. Some of the awardees tonight have participated as employers in the agricultural program for over 72 years and in the hospitality program for over 40 years. The positive nature of the terms and conditions of employment is demonstrated by the length of service of some of the awardees. Mr. Morgan, that I referred to earlier, in the agricultural program. Ms. Henry, 33 years in the hospitality program, as well as who have participated in the program for over 20 years are a testament to the success of the arrangement. Over the 77 and 50 years of operation of both programs, numerous Jamaican families have prospered, and the children, grandchildren of temporary farm and hospitality workers have gone on to distinguish themselves in professions, in the universities, and in government service. These programs have made a significant contribution to the development of the Jamaican economy. I can tell you right now as well, I have one of my assistants in my constituency, which is a rural constituency. He has excelled in the farm work program so much so that they called him in March of last year, instead of the usual May or June or that he would be called. He was called from March. He didn't come back to Jamaica until November. And he has built a beautiful house in my constituency, beautiful house, upstairs, downstairs. He rents out downstairs, and upstairs is like a palace, all through the farm work program. And so I want to thank the government of the United States for this wonderful program. And I want to say to Ambassador, don't stop the progress. That is a slogan from the opposition, my good friend. Mr. Daly will tell you, don't stop the progress. Don't stop the progress. But then also we have another slogan from my party, as we move from poverty to prosperity. Right. What's wrong? You have choking? What happened to you? Thank you so much. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Shaw. You see, when these politicians get together, I just stay over in my corner. Because they are friends, trust me. Thank you, Minister. You can tell our Prime Minister that he missed a wonderful event, but we know that he's exceedingly busy. And now we're going to go to the presentation of some scholarships. I'd like to invite Mr. Jason Smith, CEO of Yummy Jobs in London, England, to come forward. I think you want to speak for a brief while, and then you will be inviting someone up to assist with some presentations. Mr. Smith? I know you must be very happy to be in Jamaica at this time. I mean, then again, you sent some chilly weather down here yesterday, man, and some, I thought, it's because they are coming from England. Could you welcome our friends and our guests?
Yes, please. Hi, I am Pat Turnbull from Old Edwards Inn and Spa, North Carolina. And we were new to the H2B program last year, and you have won our hearts. You have won our hearts. We so did not want to give anybody back. When we were working with the H2B program, our liaison, Debbie Hutchinson, and I were talking, and I said, Debbie. Yay, Debbie, all right. We said, gosh, you know, this is great, but we use a lot of students under the J1 program. Do you have any hospitality schools? And she said, oh my gosh, yes. So Jason and I are here to talk a little bit about a scholarship program that we're ready to award to our first 9 students from Jamaica to come to our property.
Jason? So I did bring the bad weather, I apologize. You can blame Prince Harry. We love him, we do. So my name is Jason, CEO of Yummy Jobs, International Programs, but in my spare time, I set up an organization, Flight Hospitality, which actually stands for Future Leaders in Global Hospitality and Tourism. It's a not-for-profit organization. We are actually gifted a really generous amount of money by the Williams Foundation,
actually very much in true spirit of helping those who really wanted to have a great experience to come over to the US and embark on a J1 intern and training program. And with the help of Old Edwards Inn and Spa, we made that happen. So I'm very, very proud to be able to say, like Pat said, to be able to present this to 9 wonderful, inspiring young talent of our future of tomorrow in hospitality and tourism. So I'm not very good with pronunciation, so you please excuse me.
Don't leave your phone when you're done, all right. So, what a wonderful, exciting evening it must be for these people. Let's go, Brianne Bryan. Brianne, they're asking where are you from, what parish? She's at University of Technology, all right. So as you come up, just say where you're from. Turn around, we need to make the presentation. The photographer needs to get you. Don't worry, it's a rehearsal. The others will go smoothly. Clapper, congratulations. Okay, let me just do the names. Tatkia Latibodier. Is she here? Ah, here she comes. She's also a model, as you can see. I just said that. Excelsior Community College. Got that? Kimani Green. So all of the recipients, just stay on that side for us because we're going to do a group photograph after. Where's Kimani? Kimani? Kimani, you're not here? All right, let's try for another one. Is Olivia Fletcher here? Yes, come on up. Olivia? What institution? University of the West Indies. Please pardon me, that's my place. Deja Howell, did I do that right? Deja, I did it right? Deja vu. I'm enjoying this. I love when young people get a chance. Clap them, clap the persons who are thought of doing these scholarships. Jason Smith and Pat Turnbull, thank you. Let's continue with Melanie Taylor. Chantal Berger. Chantal's here. Chantal, what university? University of Technology, and then she says Jamaica. I agree. Alicia Reed. Not here as well, okay. Simone Lewis. Is Simone here? Ah. She says, the Excelsior Community College, please. Okay, Exed. What a wonderful opportunity. I think that would be The others are not here. So we're going to ask you to come on stage very quickly. We need a group photograph. Don't they make a wonderful picture? I'd like to say thank you on behalf of these recipients. Right, and it's not done. It's not done. Mrs. Grace Burnett, might I invite you to the microphone? Mrs. Grace Burnett is the CEO of Grace Kennedy Financial Services Group, and she's going to be speaking, then she's going to be inviting a colleague on stage to assist with the presentation. Will you clap her, please?
Good evening, everyone. I'm actually from a small community called Summerfield in Clarendon. And so I've actually seen the operation of the migrant program and the impact it has had. But this evening I speak on behalf of Grace Kennedy Money Services. And it's so an absolute pleasure to be here to celebrate with you the 77th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Agricultural Program and the 50th anniversary of the Jamaica-USA Hospitality Program. For the past 20 years, Grace Kennedy Money Services, through our Western Union brand and FX Trader brand, have played an active role in assisting migrant workers to maintain a bond with their families and a constant connection to Jamaica. So integral is our role that for the past two decades, we've actually had a desk at the Ministry of Labor, and we're one of the final points of contact before migrant workers leave our shores to head to the United States. I must make special mention of Prince David Royal. Prince, are you here? I think most people believe he's actually a member of the staff of the ministry. And I also want to mention here Samantha Oakley, who has been handling the desk at the ministry for the past 5 years. Once our migrant workers are in North America, they're more likely to come into contact with one or both of our community consultants. Garfield Comrie, who covers New York and Northeastern United States, or Hazel Mirage, who handles Florida and the entire Southeastern United States, both of whom are here with us this evening. I just want to acknowledge Hazel and Garfield. As part of our support of the Jamaican migrant worker, they manage a scholarship. It's a scholarship program for workers, children, who are here in Jamaica. Last year, we donated $500,000 Jamaican dollars to the program. Over the past 15 years, we have donated $20 million Jamaican dollars to the program. When we started our program, we were seeing about 4,000 workers per year. Now we're seeing close to 13,000 workers annually. We estimate that we have touched over 150 persons since we've been involved in the program. And we are so connected to these workers and their families. And that's the core of what we do. We move money for better. Our migrant workers continue to send money back home through Western Union to support their families. And when they come home, they take their foreign exchange to FX Trader to continue to fulfill their obligations to their families. The country in turn benefits, as remittances remain over 16% of GDP, with the most substantial portion of our remittances coming from the United States of America. The country benefits from remittances in ways that are too many to list tonight. But let me say that we are extremely proud of the Jamaican Migrant Worker Program. And we will continue to champion the work done by the Ministry of Labor and their partners here in Jamaica and in the United States. We pledge our continued support for the program and our migrant workers, And that's why we're going to make an additional donation this evening. I invite Margaret Campbell, Country Manager for Jamaica, to come forward. I'm going to invite Minister Xavier Main to join us. Going to be handing over to the minister a check for $300,000 Jamaican dollars to add to the scholarship fund for the children of our migrant workers. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you so very much and God bless you. Thanks.
I think we could just show our appreciation one more time. Minister Xavier, don't go too far. Come right back up here. We're going to work you tonight. All right. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the special awardees who are here, those persons who we are celebrating. We are going to be acknowledging them by inviting them on stage to accept their token and plaque of appreciation. Our presenter for the first batch is the Honorable Xavier Main, in the Minister of State. So I'm going to begin with Roy Burns. We're going to ask all of you to come from this side. Everybody, just look, you enter from this side, and when you accept, you exit on that side. Mas Roy, come here, come here, come Mas Roy, come Mas Roy. I'm about to tell you when I reach up here. 40 years, 40. Just let the photographers guide you where you are to be positioned. We want to get the best possible shot. This is something that you'll remember for a long time. All right, so thank you very much. Cecil Campbell, where's Cecil? Ma Cecil, at you. Cecil Campbell is making his way now to the stage, and he has served for 40 years, 40. All right. Following right on the heels of Cecil is Mervon Green. Okay. All right. Here comes Mr. Green, 40 years. Hello, this is not Pia Pia years, and I clap the people. Howard, that's Audley Howard, you should be next. Come on, Mas Howard. You have two names there. That could be two surname and two first name. 40 years, Audley Howard. What a moment. Henley Marshall is coming up next. So I can bring him cheering posse. 40 years, Lord, you think it's easy, man? Right. Now we're going to Noel Montague. 40 years. Oh, I love the suit here. I love the suit. 40 years again. Moving them along. Lovely. Harold Richards, you are next. I can't believe you served 40 years. Ah, yes, man, clap him. Moving along. Yes, the photographers have got it. Okay, we're moving now to George Russell. Rodney, you're not George Russell. Let's step aside and low Mars George to come home. Sure. Yes, man, right over there, Sir George. 40 years. Now I'm going to introduce John Williamson. Look upon Mars John. Yes. Yes. 40 years, man. Is what farm John work on? We need to find that out, you know. Sure. Luther Campbell. Rodney, come on, tell people in we know. Luther Campbell. Now we move up now to 41. Let's hear it. What is this? Yes, 41 years this, okay? Wonderful. Basil Hunter. Is Basil there? Who is Basil? Basil Hunter not there. Is Learbert Jackson there? All right, Mr. Jackson. So where Basil? Basil never come. Basil Hunter never come. Where Basil there? Basil, are you named Basil? Hold it, hold it. Hold on there, look at this. Go on, give Learbert. There we bring up Basil. Everybody, make sure you stay in their room, you know, because we have moved this man. 41 years from us, Learbert Jackson. All right. Basil Hunter, 41 years. All right, congrats. And Lansbert Smith, 41 years. You know, take a look at something, Mas Lansbert. Are you on, you know? Take this something, man, are you special at make fun care come here this evening? No, Leffy? Oh. Congratulations. Now for Harold Thomas. Yes, man. 41 years. All right. Henry Hay. Atio. And because of no Simas Henry Botan in shirt. Yes, sir. He must say one. 42 years. Oh, no, if you look on the boot, on the boot. In Jamaica, we really mean shoes, huh? Yes. Me, I tell you, when you see the farm workers come back and then dress and go out, you know, aye. All right, Lloyd Ingram. Mas Lloyd, 42 years. God bless you, no man. All right, look up now. At you, right so, right so. Minister, thank you so much. We're going to bring it back later on, you know, so understand that. May I ask now the opposition spokesman, Mr. Horace Daly, stop give laugh a pea soup, and could you kindly come up, please? You go and make Mr. Audishaw draw you out. Your visa is next. So, damn it. Boy, I'm taking teacher, keep a heart bone. Keith Bailey. Yes. 43 years for Mas Keith. All right, Eric Ferguson. Mas Eric. 43 years from us, Eric. Amazing, isn't it? Go over the other side, Mas Eric. At you. At you, then you say, Mas Sumail. Thomas Burrell, 44. I wonder if the man come from Clarendon. Them Burrell people come from Clarendon. Where come from? What parish come from? Me know, see there? Clarendon. Burrell come from Clarendon. Me know, man, 44 years.
I'm his MP.
All right, me here. Raymond Marshall is next. Mas Raymond, come on up. Woo-wee. 44 years again, you know. And look at these men. They look as if they are just barely 30, 35. Amazing. Raymond Marshall. Carlton MacPherson. Another 44 years of service to this program. All right. Now we're moving one up. Jediah Daly, 45 years. When you know your country, your island, you know where certain names, where them come from. I tell you. But some of them all over. Lloyd Lewis, Mas Lloyd, 45. You know, Drew. 45 years. Hello, the clapping and win. The clapping need to keep up. Look at yourself. All right. Lloyd Koch, 46 years. And at you, Cecil Mendes. Ma Cecil, how you do? You hearty? Ah, praise the Lord. What parish? What parish are coming from? In come from Albertown at Trelawney, so in nearby. 46 years. At you. Alton Bryce. No, it's stepping it up one more, you know. 47 years old, man. That's Alton Bryce. That's you. Then we're going now to Hedley Garrick. 47 years. So you see, Mr. Garrick's step. Strong stepping this, you know. Thank you. Why you have me things? You know, make up finishes. I'm going to tell you something. Thank you for that, Colin. Nehemiah O'Connor. Ah, good Bible name, you know, Nehemiah. Yeah, man. 47 years. That's right. So who is cheering for Nehemiah? Of course. Come on, let's hear it. It's boss. All right. Now watch this. Come take a picture. Quick. This is important. Hi. What is this? All right. Lascelles Peart. Mr. Peart, 47 years. 47 years. Keep the applause going, man. Jasper Harding. Where is Jasper? Where in the end of the... He's here? Where Jasper? Anybody seen since evening? All right, let me go here so now. Randall Beadle? All right. Gentleman come from Westmoreland. Anybody see Jasper Harding? All right. So, Mr. Beadle, do 49 years. Clap, Mr. Beadle. Renford Henderson, half a century, 50 years. What a thing. And him just a beam, like full moon. Where is Leston Williams? right. That's another 50 years. Is this Mr. Augustus Morgan? Mr. Augustus, Minister Shaw, 55 years. We're asking you to hand this one out, please. Right, so Mr. Daly will congratulate you, and Minister Shaw will make this presentation. Years, you know. No, man, we shall sing one serious song. All right, Mr. Daly. All right, congrats, Mr. Lally. After this, I need you to come back just after this. There's somebody who were, just give us one second. All right, thank you. Thank you, Minister Shaw. There is a gentleman standing here, and I wonder, who is this gentleman? And I get the name now. Mr. Dennis, make it they tell the people and say, yo, come here something. Come now, Sylvanus, Dennis, and 41 years at you. Hear him back at me. You want to hear him back at me? I said, sweet, you know. Lord of mercy. I love my Jamaican people. Hi. Thank you. Congratulations. Yes. Thank you, Mr. Horace Daly. Help him there. Me feel say, Mr. Dennis is outside. I take two whites, you know. Me just feel so. It might have wrong, but what's wrong with a little spirit? I sat there. Let me ask, Minister Xavier, are you here at work again? No? Come. Yes, this is U.S. hospitality now. And as you're making your way, I sat there, and Diane seems to know me a lot because she figured out I'd have done something like this. When I check up the number of years, it's over 2,100 over, because some of the people, like a few people came in after I added up. Over 2,100 years combined, Minister Shaw, of service. So it could be closer to 2,500 because a few people I didn't have their names down. Wow. All right, hospitality. And now we're going to see some of the ladies, not only the ladies, but Jacqueline Dawkins, 25 years. Madam P.S., this means a lot to these persons. This means a lot. Glendon Balgen, where are you? Are you that one there, sir? 27 years. 20, correct me, I'm telling you, say 29. All right, so me get it, so me sell it. If you tell me at 29, me put on the 2. And then I'm out of him. Anyway, me will go along on. Huh? Pastor, aren't you? Them shall quote a scripture. Shall quote Ephesians. At you. Seabird Gale, 27. This is just so wonderful. This is the hospitality now, all right? Pauline Miller, you are next. 27 years and she now left the clutch bag. Just come with the clutch bag. Me agree, it look good and it suits you. Yeah. Clytie Williams Ross, 27 years, my sister. Woo! So we had Miles Glendon earlier on. He said he was 29. I introduced the 29 now, all right? So we had Glendon, and then we're going now to Maxine Carter Henry, 29 years. That was tentative. 29 years for Miss Max. Errol Harris, 29 years. That's you. When this jacket have poppy, I want one. This is a fabulous jacket. Tell me about them money and them fashion, man. Is Milene Ferguson here? That's Milene? Ah, great. We're moving now into 31, Miss Milene Ferguson. Wow. Lovely. And then there is a lady called Colette Henry, 33 years. Sister Colette. Wow. For those of you who are visiting with us, we use terms of endearment like mass for older people out of respect. We say sister for somebody who is not a blood relative out of respect. So if you notice, I said Sister Colette just now. Thank you so much, Minister. You can sit down for a little while. All right. Minister Audley. No, ma'am, I can go on. You're watching you. I'm watching with the PS. It's your turn. Yes, Manayad must come up here again. It's good when you can have a good time. How are you? I didn't even see when you came in, so I didn't even know. I didn't. Oh, by the way, I must tell you, the Speaker of the House, I didn't see when the Mayor, the Councillor, or the Speaker came in. Of course, the Speaker said to me, round the bar, he said, how long I know you? I said, long time. He said, how old is your son? I tell him, because my son is a big man. He took out his card and give me. He gave me his card. Because him say, you never recognize me when I come in, you know. that's he, but he's gone now. See that now? Can win. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going now to the U.S. Agriculture Awardees employers. And it gives the ministry great pleasure in making these presentations. 22 years of service. Cahoon Farm Incorporated in New York, Miss Jessica Sharp. All right, for 29 years of partnership, Jarmuck Tobacco Farms in Connecticut, Mr. Owen Jarmuck. Congratulations and thanks again for partnership. 33 years of partnership. Makowski Farm in Connecticut, Miss Holly Makowski. 34 years. Southern Vermont Orchards, Miss Leah Diamond. 48 years, an employer,
for 48 years, Lakeview Orchards Incorporated, New York, Mr. Daniel Siebert. Oh, here's coming from New York. 48 years. Congratulations, sir. Right. And now, 52 years, Fairview Orchards Incorporated, Ms. Ashley Black, 52 years, woo! And then, if you thought 55 years was Mountain Orchards, 55 years. Do we have a rep from Mountain Orchards? No, no rep. And then we have Terhune Orchards, 55 years, come on. Christina Teeter, all right. 55 years. And Terhune Orchards, that is their rep here? 58 years. Is there a rep here? It doesn't appear so. Mr. Shaw, thank you, but please stay there. Yes, sir. Are you ready to continue? This is the U.S. Hospitality Awardee employers, and we are beginning with the 17-year-old in the house. The Breakers Palm Beach, Ms. Denise Bover. The 20-year-old now, Omni Hilton Oceanfront, Miss Dorothy Beek. And I'm telling you, we haven't seen each other for 4,000 years. We knew each other when we were young ladies, younger ladies. Congratulations. The 23-year-old in the house, Mackinac Seasonal Resort, Mr. Joe Leo. Or is it Ligio? What is it? He just said Joe. Mission Point Resort, another 23-year-old, Mr. Dennert Ware. Thank you so much, sir. 23 years. Do we have a rep from the next recipient, 24 years old? And that, I'm going to read your signal in just a while. The Broadmoor. Not here? Is he a rep? The Broadmoor? Yeah. Okay. The gentleman says he'll accept. Thank you so much, sir. Minister, you've drifted a little bit. The videographer at the back would like you to come two steps to your right. Yes. And remember, by the way, you know, we've been
live on three platforms. Okay. So if you're not in the right position, they're not going to see you. Yellows. Minister, thank you. Yes, because I think. Yes, because I had to put you in the right place to show Xavier where he should go.
God bless you.
Xavier, please come up here. A special award. Now, thank you, Minister. Really appreciate your graciousness. In recognition of your contribution to Jamaica's development through the employment of the largest number of Jamaican workers in the GOJ, U.S. Hospitality Employment Program over the last 3 years. And this goes to Yellowstone Club Hotel, Mr. Hans Williamson. I think we could put our hands together one more time for this achievement. And thank you, Minister. And now, Permanent Secretary, might I invite you to make these presentations. These presentations are the agent, will be made to the agent awardees. Our agents provide logistical support to the employers in terms of recruitment and transportation of workers, two very important areas. I'd like to begin with an agent who's been sharing this partnership. Are you good about there then? Yes. 58 years, New England Apple Council, Mr. Joseph Young, the executive director. I'm just seeing the arrow. For 45 years, Valley Growers, Mr. Joseph Russo, executive vice president. 45. Going to add 10 to 45 and put this one at 55. Florida East Coast Travel Services, Mr. Joseph Hobbs, Executive Director. I'm seeing you, Lorna. I'm seeing you, and you have every right. I don't know what is happening over at that table, but I'm telling you. Now, 27 years, Practical Employee Solutions, Mrs. Veronica Birkenstock, Chief Executive Officer. Thank you for your partnership. 27 years. Life is really just about partnerships, you know, whether it's at home, at school. I have to join that table shortly. 25 years. Bookends Association, Mrs. Jenny Mongeau. Thank you. And
Now we have two special presentations from Florida East Coast Travel Services. Mr. Joseph Hobbs, might I invite you up at this time? So may I ask the Consul General from the U.S. Embassy to come forward so we could make this very special presentation to you. Is our Consul General from the U.S. Embassy here still? Is the Consul General here, or is there another rep from the U.S. Embassy? Let me ask. Madam Pierce, might I ask you to just accept this on behalf of the U.S. Embassy? Minister, I'm going to ask you to accept the other one. Okay. These are the special awards from Florida East Coast Travel Services. And they're making these two special awards because they're celebrating partnership. And now for the one for the Ministry of Labor, Social Security. Yes, could you come on up, Minister, to accept? Thank you very much. Thanks for thinking in this very special way. Ladies and gentlemen, we're almost at the end of a really fabulous evening, but you know we have to say thanks, and there's somebody on the program down to say thanks. Mrs. Methelina Scarlett-Jones, Chief Liaison Officer, Jamaica Central Labor Organization, might I invite you now to the microphone. Could you welcome her?
Thank you, gentlemen. Distinguished persons here tonight. What a wonderful week it has been so far. Some of you have been here since Monday, and others are planning to have a little extended stay. So, to our visitors, especially those that are here for the first time, enjoy before you get back to the cold. I didn't hear anybody saying anything Jamaican tonight when you saw your workers getting awards. Did you learn any Jamaican words? I'm talking to the employers that are here now. No? Nothing? See Minister Main after. He gives a lesson in Jamaican. So I know that we have had a long day because we have been in meetings all morning. And I know you want to leave. But I have been given what I consider this unenviable task, which is to extend your time at the end of this very long day. But I'm asking you to please be patient with me, as it is important that we acknowledge the efforts of the persons who worked extremely hard to make this event the success it has been so far, and what I know it will be tomorrow when we have our final day. You know, when I was getting dressed to come here this evening, I don't know where this song popped up from, but it came right into my head. You know when you get the song in your head, this buzz? And it was Frank Sinatra's My Way. But then I realized it wasn't so much the My Way as, and now the end is near. You know when you have a lot to do and it starts winding down and you start singing, and then all of a sudden it occurred to me that the title of the song, My Way, and now the end is near, really bears no resemblance to the program or what is happening here tonight. Because after 77 years, I hope that there is no end in sight, let alone being near. Because we want this program to be on for a while. And then the one thing that the PS and minister will tell you, that we have never done it our way. We have always done it through the ways of the regulations. Right, PS? We do it by the US regulations. And so it is on that note that I want to express our profound gratitude to our most valued partner, which is the government of the United States of America. We have had very good participation and interaction from representatives of the Department of Labor. We've had representatives from the Department of State, and we have had two persons actually take the time to fly to Jamaica to join us because of the importance that they place on this meeting with the employers. And that is all about the regulations and getting you to understand the program more. And so we thank them, even though they apologized just now, they had to leave. We thank them for their participation. We thank Ambassador Tapia and Consul General Siebel. It was very good for them to have joined us. I mean, that just speaks to how well they honor the commitment between the United States of America and Jamaica with respect to the Overseas Work Program. So even though they're not here, could you just clap them for me, please? Thank you. Now, Minister Shaw, when I was told that you would be the guest speaker, I said, I know that PS is going to have to stay close and give you an eye and go like, because we know that your wit cannot be contained, and you were your usual comical self this evening. And so we want to thank you more so, though, for having stepped in and fill the role of keynote speaker in the unavoidable absence of our Prime Minister. Thank you so much, because we know it was at late notice. Your usual inimitable style is always commendable. Speaker of the House of Representatives, Mr. Parnell Charles, I think he has left. I want to thank him for taking time out, because he was also a former Minister of Labor. We thank him. And our Honorable Minister, Shaheeni Robinson, the Minister of Labor and Social Security, for coming out tonight and gracing us with her presence. She has oversight for the ministry, and we also thank her for her positive remarks and the takeaways and the trivia that she gave us tonight. And of course, our continuing commitment to the success of this program. Thanks to you also, Honorable Minister of State, Minister Main, for the support that you have also been given. You have been here with us since last night and today. Ambassador Marcia Gilbert Roberts, we want to thank you. She is the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade. Thank you so much for turning out, because you know we're family, right? We are annexed in the U.S. to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Thank you for coming. We appreciate. The opposition spokesman on labor and social security and special abilities, Mr. Horace Daly. I think he has left. Is he still here? But we want to thank him as well. I think you're going to miss having that light banter at the end of the day, Minister Shaw, with Mr. Daly, because he has left before you could say anything else. All right. And I need to keep my job. So I must. But it is my pleasure and distinct, I will say so, to thank our esteemed Permanent Secretary. You hear all those words, Pierce? Mrs. Collett Roberts Risen, that you have been seen buzzing around, because she buzzes. She's a small buzzer. She moves very swiftly. But thank you, Pierce Risden, for what we want to consider as you having pulled out all the stops to make this event a reality, and more so, a success. It's just that I would not be very honest if I didn't say to you that in the process of her pulling out the stops, she had many of us pulling out our hair. That's why you see there's little left here. We just saw our agents receive awards, and this is a very dynamic program. There are all different aspects of the program, and the agents are a very important component of the program. And so we would like to lend our appreciation as well to our agents. You saw them just now. I see Mr. Joe Hobbs with your 55 years, sir, of involvement in the program. Thank you. I want to thank Mr. Joe Rousseau from Valley Growers, and also to thank Joe, who acted as the representative for the employers last night and this morning and spoke on their behalf. Thank you so much, Joe. And there's just one note for Joe. Joe mentioned this morning, P.S., I don't think you were there, he mentioned that he has resigned a couple of times from his board, that he's now 83. He resigned a couple of times, and they have been taking, he's been resigning since he's 70. And so he's not sure, because he just tendered his resignation recently. But I had words with Joe, and I told him, P.S., on your behalf, that it's okay. After that resignation, he doesn't even have to submit a resume, because we'll take him. We'll accept him at the Ministry of Labor. His expertise is unmatched. He is a dynamo, and we love him. We also want to thank, you see, they say that in the H2A business, you don't get anywhere unless you're a Joe. So you heard me mention Joe Hobbs, and I mentioned Joe Russo, and I'm going to mention Joe Young from New England Apple Council. And thank you, Joe Young. I know your dad is here, and I want to acknowledge him. Oh, John, thank you so much. Thank you for all you do, and thank you for the big party that's here, that's supporting us. We want to thank Veronica Strickland as well from Practical Employment Solutions that made it here. Thank you so much. And we're thanking Jenny Munger from Bookends. Thank you so much, all of our wonderful agents. Thank you. I know you know we couldn't do this without our sponsors. And last night, our sponsor Flex kicked this thing off. Not even the rain could stop it. Everybody turned out with a positive attitude and had a wonderful night. It was a great start to this event. Thank you so much, Joe, for sponsoring our welcome cocktail reception last night. We'll call you when we need more sponsorship. Yes, if you had fun last night, you can clap, Joe. We also had our sponsorship for the scholarships, and I would like to mention them again because they have been our partners, some old, some new. We have been with Grace Kennedy Money Services, Western Union, for quite a while. Okay, cheering posse. Thank you for your generous donation. And we want to thank Old Edward Hotel and Yummy Jobs. And you know, Jason, for taking the trek all the way from London here. It's fabulous. Thank you so much. We appreciate you, and we appreciate what you're doing for our students here. Thank you so much. So during the meetings, we had a couple of coffee breaks, and those were sponsored by our partners, Jamaica National, Victoria Mutual, BPM Financial, and these are all financial institutions, and they interact with our workers because, you know, we feel it is important for them to also be aware of that other side of business. So thank you so much for what you do for our workers. I would like to thank, is this a lovely room? Very well appointed, you would say? Well, let us thank Miss Nancy McLean for the decor. She did a wonderful job with the transformation of this room into a thing of beauty. I walked in here last night, and then I came back in here tonight, and it is a thing of beauty. We also want to thank Robert Bryan and his team for their technical expertise. And how could I not mention, we call her our local songbird, Karen Smith and friends, for the wonderful, wonderful musical treat. And I will say, in a way that only Karen can. I know there are some people who are working behind the scenes, and at this time, I want to recognize the team from the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. I would like to recognize Mrs. Andrea Miller-Stennett and her team. Her team is present, but it is important to note that the Ministry of Labor has been around supporting, through past members of that team, this program for 77 years. So past and present members of the Ministry of I am going too fast. The Ministry of Labor and Social Security. All right. And then, my team, the liaison officers and the administrative team at the Jamaica Central Labor Organization, for the countless hours of stalking employers to sign up for this event. Because I get, that's what they did. They kept calling and they stalked you and they ran after you and they said, send this and send that. But hey, it worked. You're here. Right. And in the same token, because we've been around for 75 years, certainly not this team, I want to thank all of the past members that carried the banner at the JCLO. And I see a former deputy leader here, Earl White. Mr. White, I don't know if he has still left, but thank you. Thank you so much. And I want to say a very special thank you to our super talented liaison officer, Debbie Hutchinson, who produced that wonderful video feature on the H2A program. There's no way that I can leave this team out of the thank you, because they work tirelessly. Every time I see a member of the team and I say, how you doing? They say, don't ask. We have not slept yet. And that team is led by Miss Diane Spence, and she runs the secretariat, and she has been responsible for the on-the-ground planning. She has been doing everything, her fingers on the pulse. So we want to thank Diane and her team for the late nights, just to ensure that this entire program went well. And as we come to a close, let me say a very, very, very sincere thank you to the management and staff of Melia Bracco Village. We want to thank them for the courtesies extended to this group, the hospitality of the staff here, and thanks to the food and beverage team for the sumptuous meal provided this evening. I was asked to make special mention of Cheryl K. Campbell, Dion Brown, and Corrine Chin. And were you entertained tonight? Yes, you were, by our master of ceremony, Miss Faye Ellington. Where is she? Thank you, ma'am. You have done an excellent job marshaling the proceedings this evening. And finally, to our employers and workers, the reason we are all here, our heartfelt gratitude to all our Jamaican workers who have made the sacrifice to leave their families year after year to participate in the job opportunities provided through the Overseas Work Program. We want to thank you for your loyalty to your country and your employer. And to our faithful employers, we know you have choices, and you chose well when you requested Jamaican workers. Thank you for believing in our workers. Thank you for making it Jamaica. Thank you for the significant contribution to our economy. Thank you, finally, to all our invited guests for sharing in the celebration of 77 years of the H2 program partnership between the United States and the government of Jamaica. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your evening.
As we say in Jamaica, get home safely. It was great to be here. Walk good.